that. So then here, that will be our case one. Okay. So right here we have y equals 3 sine x. You know, x, the first row has the same value with the value right here. Okay. And then the second row has the same value also with sine. The only difference is that you put 3 in front of sine x. You know, between 3 and sine x is 3 times sine x. So after you get the second row, you just need to multiply every value in the second row by 3. Okay, so that looks not that hard. 0 times 3 is 0. And 1/2 times 3 is 3/2. 3 times radical 2 over 2 is 3 radical 2 over 2. 3 times radical 3 over 2 is 3 radical 3 over 2. And 1 times 3 is 3. And so on. Okay. So, here let's pick up 2 points, maybe more than that, to see how does it look like on a graph. Look, we have x is 0. Now look at this y, because this is the final y we needed. X is 0, y is 0. So still starts with 0, 0. That's important. Okay? Yeah. So even times 3 still starts with 0, 0. Sine starts with 0. Okay? Right here you see that, like this. Here the highest one is 1, lowest one is negative 1. So basically right here, this picture was the original one. Here is 1, here is negative 1. Okay, this is y equals sine, this picture. Okay. Now, this is 0, 0 we got. And pi over 6, 1x is this value. We have sine x is 1/2, because sine 30 degrees is 1/2. Okay? Times 3, then you have 3/2. So, 1x equals pi over 6. This value here. What's the value for pi over 6? Let's see. Second pi divided by 6. That's 0.52 something. Okay? And then let's say that's 0.5. Between 0 and 1 is slightly greater than 0.5. That's pi over 6. Okay? So when x is pi over 6, y is 3/2, that's 1/2. Here is 1, here is 2, in between that is 1/2. So this is the point. Previously, when pi equals 6, it was 1/2. So here, like that. That's for sine. Okay, so this is the point I picked to calculate. Let's pick another point, this point. This point is right here. This one. When x is pi over 2, we know sine x is 1, times 1 is 3. So pi over 2 is somewhere here. And then 3 is 1, 2, 3, so this high. So pi over 2, 3 is actually from here. Okay? So previously was pi over 2, 1, so is this one. Now it's higher. Okay, 2 units higher than before. Now let's look at this one. This one is pi. Sine pi is 0 times 3 is still 0, because you know, 0 times any number is 0. So here pi 0. Okay. Let's pick up this value. That's 5 pi over 4. Okay, you may pick up anything you try here. So I pick this value, 5 pi over 4. How large is 5 pi over 4? 5 pi over 4. It is like 3.9. Here is 4. Okay, so 2, 4, 6, 8. And then here 3.9, a little bit more. So this is 5 pi over 4 right here. 5 pi over 4 previously for sine corresponds to negative radical 2 over 2. Okay, negative radical 2 over 2. That's like negative 0.7 something. And here, you know, here is negative 1, so 2, 4, 6, 7. So roughly you see this high, that's for sine. Now you times 3. That's negative 2.1. Okay, here is 2, and 2.2 is here, so it's between these two. So it's right here. Okay, that's negative 2.1, a little bit more than that. Yeah. So in this case, you have a negative, negative 3 radical 2 over 2 is down right here. Okay? This point. Now, how about the lowest point? Lowest point is somewhere here. X equals 3 pi over 2. For sine is negative 1. Yeah, 3 pi over 2 is roughly somewhere here, okay? Negative 1 is right here. And then you have a 3 pi over 2, this is negative 3, okay? Because your negative 1 times positive 3, you have negative 3. So it's right here. It's right here. So it gets lower, okay? And then sine pi is 0, you times 3, so you still get 0, okay? So it's down here. So then the picture goes like this, goes like this. Okay, so this tells us that previously the highest one was 1, now the highest one is 3. Okay, the lowest one was negative 1, now is negative 3. So then the amplitude is changed from 1 to 3. That's the meaning if you put the coefficient instead of 1, if you put 3 here, what's going to happen? Okay, this is 3 is called the amplitude of this function. Okay, there are two things we may want to think about. Okay, one thing is that how about negative 3 sine x times negative 3? Previously, if you 1 times 3, you have a 3 this high. If you times negative 3, here will be negative 3 for y. Then it goes down. Okay, so if it's negative 3 sine x, the picture will be goes to the negative 3 back to 0. And then back to positive 3 goes down. Because here is negative 1. If you times negative 3, it's going to be positive 3. So this one goes up. Okay? So it goes like this. That's one thing you want to consider. Another thing is y equals 1/2. Sine x, maybe 1/3, okay? So how does the picture look like? So in previously, if it was 1, it's this high. If it's 1/2, then it's this high. So the picture looks like compressed, okay? Yeah, you want to try this one yourself. This is case 1 for amplitude. So basically is y equals sine x times a coefficient. So this one is not really that hard. All right.